Very simple, no? Process flow of how the tabless cylindrical cell are produced. Okay, the first process is winding, where we create the jelly roll. Then there is the current collector disc welding that we see later on. Jelly roll insertion into the can. Jelly roll to can terminal welding. Anode disc to can welding. Lead to can sealing. Electrolyte filling. Temporary closing, and then we go to the pre-charging that activate, okay, the battery cell. Right now could be very confusing, but in the next slide, we are going in detail for each process, and you can see really how the product changed now through the manufacturing process. All this process from winding to the can closing occur, take place in a dry room, okay? Dry room is a control environment with very low humidity value, control temperature, usually 21, 22 degrees, where we can produce battery cell, okay? Otherwise, there's no reason to dry up our electrodes, okay? If we produce the battery cell in wet environment, okay? The water is an enemy for lithium ion battery cell. So we don't want to have water in our compounds. So the product should be dry, the environment should be dry. Only once the case, okay, of the batteries, the case of the cell, the case that contain completely the cell is sealed. So the environment inside the case is insulated by the environment that is outside the case. Only at that moment, we can move the production in not dry area, okay? But should be at least a temperature control area. This is why if my case is sealed, there's no way for the moisture to move in the cell, okay? So we can start for the winding, okay? There are two philosophies to produce the tabless cylindrical cell. First, unwind the material and then wind directly on the winding spindle, okay? With this kind of pattern. So separator, anode, separator, cathode. Or once the material is unwind by the reel, have an intermediate laser notching system, okay? The laser notching system create what are called flecks. Okay, so instead of have continuous, okay, metal foil here, after the laser cutting system, we have many flecks, many flecks. And then again, the material flow into the winding unit to create the jelly roll. Only cathode and anode will pass through the laser cutting system, okay? Not the separator, no way. The separator moves directly from unwinding unit to winding unit, okay? Just anode and cathode can pass through the laser cutting system, but is a choice, okay? That means that we can have battery cell without laser cutting system or battery cell with laser cutting system. When I talk about laser cutting system and to produce flag, I mean produce something like this. Okay, this is a picture. Okay, this is my copper foil. On lower side, you can see a small area of coating. Okay, and the flags are this. Okay, so with my laser system, I cut here, 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 and here. Okay, so I produce these flags. I have different technologies to use for this kind of laser cutting system. The pulsed laser are the best technology to do that. Since we are going to cut just the metal foil, the best choice ever is the picosecond pulse laser that allow the machine maker to cut up to 20 meters per second. A good compromise in terms of cost and performance is a nanosecond pulse laser that is cheaper than the picosecond laser, but can guarantee just up to 10 meters per second, okay, in terms of cutting speed. Here, I think, is a very, very representative picture how the two cell design looks like, okay? I mean, on the left side, you have a cylindrical cell, tabless, without laser notching. So you can see the continuous coils of copper foil. On the right side, you have a cylindrical tabless cell with flags, so with laser cutting system, okay? Each of this one is a flag, okay? So during the winding, there is a system that bends the flags and create this characteristic pattern, okay?